bare-face censorship. That's how the Communist Party of the Philippines described the National Security Council's order to have its website banned. Over 20 other websites, including that of alternative news outlets Bulatlat and Pinoy Weekly, as well as fisherfolk group Pamalakaya, have been blocked by the National Telecommunications Commission for allegedly being affiliated with or supportive of the CPP, which has been designated by the government as a terrorist organization. But the CPP insists only 7 of the banned sites have official links to them. CPP spokesperson Marco Valbuena describes the blocking as a desperate move to censor online criticisms and dissent. It also accused the NSC of using anti-terrorism as a supposed pretext to clamp down on basic people's freedom. Malacanang spokesperson Martin Andanar and Justice Undersecretary Adrian Sugay say there are remedies for those who feel aggrieved by the order.
A Philippine official defends the government's move to block several websites which it claims are linked to communists. Interior Undersecretary Jonathan Malaya says National Security Advisor Hermogenes Esperon has the right to order such a move, saying it's based on evidence. Esperon did not actually cite any evidence except to claim that the websites had released disinformation which aims to discredit the Philippines, recruit members, and solicit funds from local and international sources.
This has basis, no? Kailangan natin bigyan ng pagkakataon ang National Security Council to reveal the basis for this. The National Security Advisor has all the data needed. And I don't think he would have made that request to the National Telecommunications Commission without basis.
That move by government comes amid claims communist groups are plotting to disrupt the inauguration of President-elect Ferdinand Marcos Jr. on June 30.
This was made very clear by the former rebels who appeared during the press briefing last Monday. And the former rebels informed us and exposed to the public that organizing is currently happening in Tarlac, for example, and in other provinces in Luzon for purposes of mobilizing people to possibly disrupt the inauguration. Mm-hmm. We are prepared to counter any attempt to disrupt the organization, the inauguration, and that the Philippine National Police, which is part of the DILG, is mobilizing all its available resources to ensure that we have a peaceful transition of power come June 30. To assemble peacefully is a constitutional right. Therefore, what we're saying to them is, you can hold your protest actions so long as these are within the bounds of the law. The law provides for freedom parks. And freedom parks are located everywhere in Metro Manila. No? Liwasang Bonifacio is there, Plaza Moriones, Plaza Miranda. Hold your events there. Huwag po kayo makipaggitgitan sa police, no? Sa araw ng inaugurasyon, kasi hindi po natin hahayaan yan. We will not allow that to happen precisely because the entire country is looking for a peaceful transition of power, no? We have 31 million people voting for the president-elect, and we have to respect the decision of the people.
Pamalakaya asserts it is not in any way affiliated with communist rebel groups. For Pamalakaya National Chairperson Fernando Hicap, the blocking of their website only shows government's unwillingness to hear out the legitimate concerns of small Filipino fishermen.
Kung yung aming panawagan na dapat ay palayasin ang mga China dyan sa West Philippine Sea, yun po ay batayan para kami sabihin na front o member o ng CPPNP o ng komunista, ay hindi po katanggap-tanggap yun, no? Kung ang paglaban namin dito sa mapanirang mga reklamasyon tulad nitong nagaganap dito sa Manila Bay, ang pagtutulba rito ay gawain ng mga komunista o terorista. Kung ganun, ay talagang maaari na terorista ako dahil talagang tututulan namin at talalabanan namin at hindi kami mapapatahimik.